Hello everyone, welcome back to Critics News on another edition. On I don't already know how we take the do. So as we take see the matter, so now so we take the talk. Let's go straight to the reason why we are here. As you can see, what we are hearing is that the government of Nigeria wants to negotiate with Mazen Nnamdi Kanu, and they are giving him some ye document to go and sign inside DSS detention. I say, wow. You see the brain of Fulani, say he never complete. The brain of the president, the brain of the people, the cabals, ruining Nigeria, say he never correct. It is not correct. Because if their sense correct, you will know, say you cannot be negotiating with a man in chains. It's not proper. You cannot do that. That's the same reason why I told you the last time when they said that Mazen Nnamdi Kanu said that we should cancel Sitatomo. I told you guys that such orders cannot hold because he's still in detention. So why are they, if it is proper now, so why are we rejecting him signing the document when he's still in the DSS custody? So he can't sign it. He must be free, released, and be able to walk around like every other person. Then anything you bring to him, he will sign it with his mosque mind. Because church mind, when I don't use and finish. Okay, let's quickly look at that. Because his lawyer reacted to that. And here, the man in cage, which is the vice president, Osibanjo, said that only factories can save Nigeria. Say, no, muna no build factory. Muna define open grazing up and down. That is what we save on. Yeah, people, now you know. How many factories have this government built since they are coming, since they came into power? How many? No deal. It's improper to negotiate with Nnamdi Kanu while still in detention because they are pressurizing him to sign documents that we cajole what we are doing. Lawyer Ejimakọ tells Nigerian government. A lawyer Ejimakọ, one of the counsels, which is the special counsel to Mazen Nnamdi Kanu, the detained leader of the Indigenous People of Biafra, IPOB, has lamented the despicable act of the Nigerian government to frustrate his client's freedom. The lawyer has, however, disclosed how to negotiate the pro-Biafra separatist group leader. Ejimakọ argued that Mazen Nnamdi Kanu should gain his freedom first from the custody of the Department of State Services, which is DSS, before the government could start any form of negotiation. Okay, it's not telling him you want to negotiate while he's still in detention. No. Such is not it's not welcomed. It is unacceptable. He pointed out that Nelson Mandela of South Africa, Gandhi of India, and Martin Luther King of the United States were released before the government of their countries negotiated with them. Do you now see it? Do you see it? Do all those ones are Obodoyibo, but the brain of a black man is telling him that they want to negotiate with him under chains. You know, we are negotiating with him. In a tweet, the lawyer said it's unnatural to negotiate with Nnamdi Kanu while being detained. When a man is in detention and you wish to negotiate with him, the first step you take is to stop resisting every effort being made to release him from detention. That's how they negotiated with Mandela, Gandhi, and Martin Luther King. It's unnatural to negotiate with a man in chains, Ejimakọ tweeted. Kanu has been in the detention of the Nigeria Secret Police since June, when he was forcefully kidnapped and brought extraordinarily renditioned to Nigeria from Kenya. The Nigeria government had since has said he was brought back to the country to continue his trial for treason. The IPOB leader is expected to appear before Justice Binta Nyako-led Federal High Court sitting in Abuja on October 21st, which is this month. The 21st of this month is the day when Mazen Nnamdi Kanu will be going to Abuja. So, and we expect to see him there, nothing more, nothing less. And we expect his freedom as well. So tell the Ohanaeze Ndị Igbo that they should stop this, the ceasefire, and you are bringing oppression down, which is killing people up and down. Instead of them to go and meet them, to tell them to get away from Biafra land, you are there talking trash, beating around the bush. Now the fear face, ye ye destiny. Let me quickly go to Osibanjo when he said that factories only can save the nation. But are they building factories? The answer is no, they are not. Only factories will save Nigeria, not Central Bank of Nigeria. Sometimes you wonder if Vice President Osibanjo is part of Nigeria national government. I write that because he has many great ideas, but who will give him the opportunity to transmit them into the system? Nobody is going to give him such opportunities. It's not possible. Now, he said that those ideas, they don't want to bring those ideas into actions, and those things remains the missing link. He has no opportunity. That's why I always tell you guys that he's in cage. He's in chains. He doesn't have the power of his own to do things. Of course, if Osibanjo is given an opportunity, I know that he will do well. But no such opportunity. And that is why I'm telling you that the country must be divided, so that since he has sense, he can bring that sense to his Oduduwa people. Okay? No, nobody with this government can do anything better. I know Osibanjo is a very good man, but if you shake body there, they don't move him through it. He no go even last. He no go read 2 days. The vice president said this on Monday during a speech at the midterm ministerial performance review, okay, retreat, which was held at the banquet hall, Presidential Villa Abuja. He noted that Nigerians' officials' exchange rate is artificially low, asking the Central Bank of Nigeria to rethink its strategy in tackling the forex crisis. Since they arrested, Ali Abi FX, something FX, is it Alibaba FX, Abi waiting? Has the Naira grown since they closed that man's business because of Anyaofu? Has the Naira grown? The answer is no, it has not grown. So they need to find the solution, not arresting people who are doing their legitimate businesses and telling them that they are the problem of a Naira. Does the man destroy factories? Does he close businesses? Is he Fulani herdsmen? Those things are the factors killing us. Not the people who are doing their normal businesses. You go there and destroy their business, but you want Fulani herdsmen to be rearing cattle up and down in the country. But somebody who is doing online business, you say he's the problem of Naira. See the sense we will not get. He said that he is convinced that the demand management strategy currently being adopted by the CBN needs a rethink. All those are issues I'm sure that when the CBN governor has time to address, he will be able to address in full, he said. There is no way you would expect me to invest at 410 Naira or dollars and cash out at 570 Naira or dollars. Oh yes, you are talking of devaluation, which means the Naira has been has to be devalued to say 480 Naira to dollar. A number I think is possibly by next quarter, and that will happen, and another cycle will come. But what will not fix anything until Nigeria begins to ramp up production? We don't have any form of production in Nigeria. What we have is how we can rear cattle. So that takes me to the national budget, which was pegged at 410 Naira per dollar. Privately, I noted to some friends that our national budget is already off by more than 30% in absolute purchasing expendable value because the exchange rate is not realistic. That is what the man in cage was saying. He has a lot of qualities, he has a lot of ambition, he has a lot of dreams to make the so-called failed country better, but those things are not cannot be realized because the people ahead of him, the cabal, they have pressed him that he can't even do he can't do anything. So the country will continue to languish in agony. Let me play you this song, but we'll take this one to jollificate before we move. Hey. back on your headset. Use your headset. You understand this music. Even this lady, this Miss Savvy, she's speaking Igbo. When I was a DJ,
is the pressure, the world needs refresher. He knows which buttons to press for a pressure. He thinks the truth is like a fire. No space for nonsense, but can be buyer.
Oh.
He's courage like a choir. Army is singing. Get out of Biafra, you cannot take it. These moments blind, you can't educate it. Stop preaching lies, we know you are shaking. I am Ankwekwa, Nigeria is breaking. Get out of Biafra, you cannot take it. The entire world is tired of you. Stop preaching lies, it is game over. No one will help you, I am Ankwekwa. I no get anything to tell you. This conversation is over. This brutality was too much. You thought you could win, but God is taking over. Pull over, pull, he looks over. ESN taking it, taking you sober. Chinekemo, every day we are closer. Biafra is here, it's game over.
All right. Okay, let's end it there. So that's our sister, Miss Savvy. That's her social media handles, in case you want to locate her. That's her social media handles, Miss Savvy. Okay, she did a very nice job there. And I love that music. Okay, let me know what you think about it. But Mazi Nnamdi Kanu needs to be free first before you can talk about any negotiations. They are pressing him to see whether he will sign what. He's useless, but I know Mazi Nnamdi Kanu, he's very resolute, and so am I. Are you resolute? We are resolute to the end, not before mouth. Men with action, now they talk so. Thank you.